We now come to the equation of the plane that passes through the intersection of two planes. Okay. Now you see, this always will happen whenever an n-dimensional object will intersect. It will give you an n minus 1th dimensional object. Like what? If two lines intersect, what is the dimension of a line?
One
dimension. So it will always give you a zero dimensional point. Okay. Plane is what dimensional? Two dimensional figure. Why? Because it's got length and breadth but has no depth. So it's two dimensional figure. Whenever it will intersect, it will give you a one dimensional thing, that is a line. Okay. This will always happen. Now what if two planes, two solids intersect? Then what will happen? Then it will give you a plane. 3Ds, if three dimensional things intersect, they'll give you a 2D, that is a plane. How? Because the object that will lie on the place where they intersect, that will always be a plane, two-dimensional object.
If these markers intersect,
they are 3Ds, right? Mm-hmm. Now, when you say they intersect, what do you mean?
At the point which they meet.
I mean, how will they intersect? That means you will have to somehow melt them and fuse them in. Okay. Now, what is that which is common to both of them? What is there that is common to both of them? What is that surface that is common to both of them? So it is like this. This goes out, and you have something like this. So or you say you have something like this. Okay. Now what is that which is common to both these? What is that? Leave it for time being. What is that which is common to, so say this fuses there and this becomes the projection. So what is that which is common to both? Which part?
The portion that you have covered with the index.
You know, here it will be this thing. No? This is common to both. Okay? This is common to both. What next? When you go down? When it is going like that? That's also common to both? So also here. What else? Is there something else that is common? What else is common? If it cuts, are you able to understand what will happen?
It will be something like this, and this, and there will be maybe this kind of figure, and this, and no? This and this, this and this and this, and there'll be this also.
Yes sir. जहाँ से ये जा रहा है, ये जा रहा है, ये जा रहा है और ये जा रहा है. Now what does it form? total, if you see, what does it form?
A plane here,
and a plane there, and a plane here, and a plane there. Okay. What else? Does it contain something else? Yes. It also contains the area that is in between, the volume that is in between. No. No. Is that common to both? Is that common to both?
Yes.
So what happens? This has a capacity of giving you a 3D or a 2D. If a 3D is cut by a 2D, for example, there's a cone and you cut it by a plane, what do you get? You'll get a plane. That is common to both. That will be a plane. So 3D cut by a 2D will be a plane, but 3D cut by a 3D will be a 3D object. Okay, and then it becomes more complex from there. But we have got capacity in 3D to find out that area or volume that is common to both. Okay.
So, sir, the number of planes would be 2.
Number of planes may be more. Four.
In this case.
In this case, there will be 4 planes.
The number of dimensions.
Planes will be 4, but whatever is common, the volume that is common to both will be this fusing. You understand? Mm-hmm. I melt and fuse it, so it becomes a plus kind of thing. Now that plus is what? It is common to this, and some part of it is common to that. Okay. So that in itself is a 3D figure. You understand that? So 3D by a 3D becomes 3D. 3D by a 2D becomes 2D. Okay. So now what are we trying to do? We are trying to find out, see, suppose this is a plane. This is a plane. And another plane comes and cuts it. I think I should be able to draw it. Hold on. It looks like two planes intersecting?
Yes, sir.
More so?
Yes, sir.
Right. And this is the line that we are getting. It's kind of your book, where all these pages you can consider to be planes and they are intersecting at the spine of the page. Right, they are intersecting at the spine of the page of the book. Okay, so that becomes the point of intersection of all these. Though due to the thickness, what has happened? It has not remained a line. It has become itself a plane where they cut. But forget that. So what happens? I get a line that is common to these two planes. Okay, so the intersection of the two planes is a line. Two obviously non-parallel planes is a line. Okay, now let those planes be let the planes be R is equal to, look, in the normal form we had seen it is like this, R dot n1 cap is equal to d1. That is the normal form of the plane. And R dot n2 cap is equal to d2, where yes, if this is the vector, this is the normal vector, unit normal vector, and if this is unit vector, then the right hand side is the distance of the plane from the point, from the origin. So this, let the planes be this, correct? Now this line, okay, it lies on both the planes. The line formed due to the intersection of planes lies on both the planes. Okay, this lies on both the planes, correct? Now let T, okay, so let T be the position vectors which lie on the line. Okay, let T be all those position vectors which lie on the line. So there'll be so many, there'll be infinite. Our origin is somewhere here. Our origin is say somewhere here. It could be anywhere. Okay, so maybe our origin is like this. Okay, and this is our origin, and we are talking about what position vectors? See, this position vector, this lies on the line. So let this be T1, then there will be this, and there will be so many in between, right? It's not that there are only these two, there's so many in between. I'm just showing for the clarity sake, like that. And then there will be something in between. So this is maybe T3. Okay, I'm talking about all these, and I name them together as a general vector T. I'm not naming them as T1, T2, because then I'll have to name infinite. So all those vectors, all those position vectors which lie, all those points which lie here, and the corresponding position vectors I call as T. Okay, now if T lies on the line, okay, since the line is common to both the planes, what happens? Since the line is common to both the planes, T lies on both the planes, and hence satisfies both 1 and 2. Is it not? It will satisfy both 1 and 2. Therefore, T dot n1 cap is equal to d1. Where have I substituted it? In place of R. R was what? R is all the position vector of x, y, z, right? R is any position vector on the plane. R represents XYZ. You have to involve XYZ if you are talking about a 3D. You have to involve XY if you are talking about a 2D. You have to. No other choice, right? So T dot N1 is D1 and T dot N2 cap is D2. Correct? Now, so T dot N1 cap plus lambda times T dot N2 cap is equal to D1 plus lambda 2. हमने उसको इंट्रोड्यूस किया. आई हैव इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इट. व्हाट आई डिड, आई मल्टीप्लाइड दिस बाय लैम्डा, दिस बाय लैम्डा. सो टी इनटू एन टू कैप बिकम्स लैम्डा इनटू डी टू. आई डिड दिस एंड देन आई एडेड द एलएचएस एंड द आरएचएस. ओके. Now, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Due to a reason that I'll tell you just when the equation comes out, right? So this is fine because these were getting satisfied. I multiplied the second by lambda on both sides. Then I added both the equations. I can add equals to equals and they'll still be equal, right? So this was equal to this. This was equal to this. I added this, so this will also get added. Simple. Is that okay? Now just think and logic out. What are we talking about? This represents something which is satisfied by T. That is number one. That means whatever this is, okay, what I'm trying to say is, I'm trying to say this. If I have R dot N1 cap plus lambda R dot N2 cap is equal to D1 plus lambda D2 as my equation of something, whatever. I'm not saying what, but if this was my equation, then T lies on this. Why? Because if I put T here, that is true. Do you understand that? This is at times a leap of faith. But you'll find what? This was my reaction when I was given this. What? Why? I don't believe this. Because I had fights with my teacher. No. So it took me some 3-4 in school, obviously 5-7-10 classes to understand what it was. So what I'm just trying to say, if this is equation of something, it is a equation of crap. Okay, forget it. What is this? What this equation represents? Just forget that. Whatever this equation represents, at least I know that T lies on that. Is it not? Okay. That means this is the equation of something that passes through this. Why? Because T lies on that line. T lies on this. It means this passes through the intersection of this. Do we get that? At least I am one thing is sure. I do not know what it represents yet. Okay? But I know one thing, that it passes through the intersection of this. Why? Because if T satisfies these two, then it satisfies this also.